Hello, dear centers. My name is Etalyx, and today we return to that land of famine and disease, and most importantly for us, toxic radioactive snow falling from the heavens indefinitely. When last we left off in the Bolt Collective colony, I was attempting to enclose it. There's a wall to the southwest, a raid, and a wall to the northeast to try and roof most of the interior of our colony here. There's a few pockets still remaining where the snow can get through, but I think for the most part our colonists are safe walking outside. Of course, that precludes the idea of raiders coming to assault us. This is going to be problematic for a couple different reasons. What do we have here? A pump shotgun. I really could use some more weapons, so I'm not super opposed to this raid. But where are they? Way to the east. Now, here's the problem, of course. If they break down the door to get in, which they need to, it might de-roof the entire roofed sector. We're gonna find out how this works the hard way. I didn't read. Are they attacking immediately? They are. So there's not even going to be enough time for the toxic snow to poison them, weaken them for us. We need to wake everyone up and make sure that they're all armed. Our two prisoners, still unwilling to join our colony, recruitment difficulty of 96 on one and 56 on the other. So Irioth is going to join us very soon. It's only a matter of time, but Stoll, on the other hand, being very, very ornery. Ginny is in need of a weapon, and I'm having trouble remembering what everyone is good at here. Tony has a pistol. Case doesn't have a weapon either, so we got two people without weapons. Eden can't help us at all, and Tally has the rifle. This is going to be an interesting fight due to the fact that two of them have personal shields and melee weapons. They're going to be able to get in real close to us. Those personal shields, I have found out, block many different types of bullets, but will not block close-range melee. So our melee fighters are going to have to duke it out one-on-one with them. Now let's take a look into our stockpile and see what we have access to. Some grenades. Grenades have worked out for me in the past. Might be worth fitting Ginny with them because Ginny doesn't really have any other skills. Interest, sure, but immediate skill, no. So let's equip those frag grenades here. Tally's got the rifle, Eden can't do jack, and Case, please don't go crazy on me now, Case. Let's check your mental state. Looking good, looking good. I think I'm gonna make you one of the meleeers. What is this, a plasteel knife? Yeah, that's gonna be what you take up. So we got a pistol, rifle, a melee, and a grenadier. We're gonna wake up the other ones. Tally and Tony, get up! It's time to fight! And I also should probably turn on and redesignate power to my other auto turret. Apparently this steel improvised turret was built up and I didn't even realize it. Hey, you two. There's no time for food right now. We are under attack. Are they going south instead of east? Interesting. I wonder where they're gonna try to break in. What if they go through this wall right here? This is what I've been— No, they are! I was very worried about this. Maybe we should open one of the doors. All right, hold open the door. Tally, come on in. We might have to go out to meet them. What are you throwing grenades at my wall now too and catching it on fire? All right, well, I've got the door open for you guys. You wanna come in through that way? Okay, one does. Maybe the other ones will change their mind and head up here in just a second. Let's get our gunman in position, Ginny. And then Case, you're gonna hide out to the right here to try to stab them when they come in. Now, if somebody could be so kind as to flick the switch, that would be wonderful. No, I don't, just stay right there. Thanks. Here we go! It's time to test out our brand new auto turrets. We broke the shield and Blue is attacking. Okay, so everyone, I don't really want you to throw any more grenades, Ginny, so why don't you just get on the move? The other two, you shot Blue the dog! What is going on here? We're gonna melee attack the pump shotgunner. Colonist needs treatment immediately, really. Okay, come on, team. Oh no, I am not microing this well at all. That grenade, Ginny, took out Case and the pump shotgunner. Not at all what was intended, and our colony wall is on fire. This is truly awful. This building's on fire, but who cares about that? You can burn that, you anarchists, all you want. We need to rescue poor Case. You know, Case, you kind of deserved it, but I didn't want you to die. Ginny, you're in charge of rescuing Case. Is this payback for when Case beat you up in the prison cell moments ago? It very well could be. Now, who else do we have? Oh, Eden doesn't even know what's going on. Didn't hear the explosions, the gunfire, nothing, just chilling. Sound asleep. turn power off to both of our auto turrets, and of course we want to shut the door once again, just because. Good news is, we picked up a pump shotgun, I guess. That's something. I wonder if Case is gonna live. Who is in charge of making sure that Case lives? I forget who's the designated nurse. Aiden. Aiden, get up. It's time to wakey-wakey go grab some medicine. Now, one good thing. I didn't realize I had the foresight for this, but our medicine's being kept very, very close to the medical ward. So I'm happy with that. I didn't really intend for it to go that way, but it did. Let's check on your health once again. Cracked radius, cracked right tibia, your shredded right leg and left arm and torso and extreme pain. Well, this is just too bad, isn't it? Give him some morphine, Eden. Give him the good stuff. Don't worry, team. I didn't forget about Blue the dog, who took some cuts like a champ. A gunshot to the body, that was friendly fire. There was nothing I could do about that. And I know we're basically out of medicine. I've also changed the display for all the resources over here. There is a toggle for categorized mode, and this allows me to minimize things like this giant list of leathers. So there's not 10 different leathers on the screen for no apparent reason. We can go into more finer detail if I want to, like if I want to see what kind of meat we have, for example. Or if I don't want to see the food at all, I can minimize that whole list. But anyways, I don't mind that we have a little bit of medicine right now, because we're about to harvest a brand new set of heal root, and it's daytime, and I totally forgot to designate power to all of our sun lamps so the crops can keep growing. This little patch right here, I guess, is going to keep growing no matter what, because it is technically in the sun. Oh no, that is the worst possible spot for lightning. Now I have to expand the allowed area, because they're only allowed to go into area one right now. And I need you to put out this fire immediately before it breaks down our electric grid. Okay, good job, Eden. That was actually a lot faster than I thought was gonna happen. And we need to clear it once more. That'll probably work for us. And I want to make sure that we have a new dump zone. It occurs to me that the dump zone's way over here to the left. There's no accessible route, or to the north. They can't really get up there, plus that one's full. We need somewhere to put all these stones, don't we? So for now, I'm just gonna do a dump stockpile down here at the southwest. And I don't know what to do with all these rocks. We need a research bench so we can start cutting those rocks down into usable building materials. Hey, a little extra patch of roof here is good. I think our roof's now finally done. Awesome. Poor Callie Joy Wirer. What a name. Dead. At the foot of our turret being buried at this moment. Which reminds me, let's queue up a couple more graves. Not right there, though. I missed, just by a little bit. How's our food situation doing? At the end of the last video, I designated fine meals instead of simple meals. Why fine meals? Well, I believe that fine meals are a combination of two different types of foods. It should be 5 and 5. So, whereas a simple meal is 10 of any type of food, a fine meal, I think, is 5 of meat and 5 of veggies. See? 5 of each being cooked into a nice, fine meal. And I've got it to where we're making up to 20 of those at the same time. We're currently up to 15, so we got a nice little stockpile here. What's going on? Aiden successfully recruited what is your name? Irioth. I don't know. Good enough. On a 19% chance. Brand new colonist. Unfortunately, we don't have a bed for you, do we? I think it's high time that we designate a new mining job. We haven't done any mining in a while. We don't really have the wood for the furniture that's going to be needed to furnish this new room. So for the time being, this is just going to become a new colonist room, I suppose. Better than nothing, right? And traders are here. Good luck, traders. You got a bunch of pigs and an alpaca and elephants and buffalo and a mad animal, a local boomalope. We'll hopefully attack the raiders, or not the raiders, the visitors instead of us. Where do those visitors even go? They're probably gonna be making their way up into our camp here pretty soon. Why are they taking damage? What's wrong with your health? You're burned? From what exactly? I don't know. I am not going all the way to the southeast to try to trade with you, though. If you want to trade, you can come up here. Maybe you can start a farm. Get some piggies and start having them breed with each other and harvest them for meat. We do have a stockpile of 870 silver. Maybe it would be worth buying a new animal, but what animal? How can I resist buying an elephant? That just sounds amazing. Could we mount the elephant and ride it into battle? That's what I want to do. Also, what are you doing out here? You are not restricted to the same areas that the rest of our colonists are. That's the problem. And let's check and see what you're good at for work purposes. Ah, yes, you are the cannibal, aren't you? You like to eat human flesh. I wonder how you're going to interact with the rest of the colonists, if they know that about you or not. Is it a secret? You could be our dedicated researcher. You're capable of dumb labor, not skilled labor, which I think I incorrectly interpreted previously. That means you can be a dedicated cleaner. Irioth is going to be our dedicated animal tamer to help out with Tally, get Blue trained, and also whatever new animals we decide to purchase. And also, going to haul and clean and plant cut. Yep, that's all nice and dandy. In order. Has the sun gone down yet? It has. It's time to turn out our lights. As soon as the rice plants are resting, and now they are. Where are those traders? Finally making their way in here. How's your health doing? Yeah, toxic buildup. It takes a long time to get in here. Didn't you know that there's nasty poison falling from the skies at all times? Pick a strange time to visit me, but come on inside. It's kind of safe in here anyway. not super safe. Who is our best talker? We have like four people who are great at being warden. Jenny the barkeep has the most social skills though, so let's see if we can trade. Curious how much these elephants and other animals cost. That's a lot of stuff on the screen all at the same time. I really want to try breeding some pigs. This is a possibility. We'll buy one male pig. One female pig. That's only 546. It's not too bad. We've got 870 total, plus whatever we can trade. Maybe I should trade away some of these different types of skin. But then again, we need to make clothes for winter. I forgot. We need a crafter. Oh, that's going to be very important. How about we focus on that the rest of this episode? We could trade away Blue the Husky for 100... No, you wouldn't want to do that, would you? An alpaca might be able to haul stuff for us. Oh, well, let's just go with this. Two pigs. I accept your trade. Which one are ours? Wait, are they already getting to it? Pig one and pig two are already having hearts flowing from their loins. I hope we can eat some delicious pig loins. Anyway. Unfortunately, these piggies have some toxic problems, but hopefully that'll go away. Wonder if we can train them. Obedience training seems like a first good place to start, and it looks like piggy number one, or sow number one, has taken Blue's sleeping spot. We're gonna need some more little animal pets, apparently. Let's queue those up now and get them in some different rooms. Here we go. Two, three, four, and five, just to kind of future-proof everything. Plus, we want them to be comfortable, don't we? We want those fancy cloth beds. We've been growing cloth. Should be okay. Pigs are smart animals, aren't they? They can be trained to attack, rescue, and haul. All of the above. Pretty cool. We're gonna make a farm. I'm excited. Okay, what was I doing? Yes, we're digging out a new room for our newest colonist, the cannibal. And we're going to start working on a research room and a crafting table. Now, what do I want to be what? I think this could be both, actually. So let's finally start this digging process. Make sure it's on 3x speed, and we'll be able to squeeze in both a research bench and a crafting table on either side. Now, the stockpile is going to be very far away, so this wasn't really good in terms of foresight for us, but too late. The damage has been done. And I want to mine this out and designate it as a stockpile zone. So we're going to be moving all this stuff inside, deleting this stockpile zone and hauling everything in here instead, and then hauling all these rocks out into the trash. It seems like Stoll has only like a 1.6% chance to be recruited into our colony. I wonder if we should torture him. Okay, no, we're not going to do that, but I think we should release this prisoner. Just consuming our food and almost no chance of joining the colony. It's kind of not worth it, so I'm just going to let him go. And it'll also improve our relationship with the snipers. Why is there just constantly fire on this map? Oh my, the whole map is on fire. We've gone from Armageddon stage one to hell stage two. The fire is encroaching from all around us. I also kind of want to double wide this steel wall. I don't really want people to walk out there to do that. But I'm going to queue it up now so eventually we'll be able to make it happen. After that last attack, it's kind of scary. Possibility of them sneaking through the medical bay. I don't like it. Not one bit. You don't want to join our colony, Stoll? Well, brave the elements. We have no roof for you anymore, buddy. Get out. Tally, I guess, is able to walk down here for whatever reason, circumventing my restricted zone. Currently not experiencing any toxic buildup problems, so I guess this is okay. Laying the groundwork for this double wide wall. I think it's necessary anyway, so this is good. Speed things up. Do our piggies have a name yet? I can actually toggle the names like this so we don't lose them. Right now, still Pig 1 and Sal 1. That's okay. Stay away from the grenade, Sal. Do you guys want to maybe give me one of your elephants? I bet the elephants can haul so much stuff at the same time. Speaking of hauling, who's going to get our pump shotgun? Maybe our newest cannibal colonist. Let's see what your shooting skill is. I forget. It's not great. Probably give you the pistol and have somebody else take over the shotgun. Tally's been going strong with the sniper rifle. Tony, I think, currently has the pistol and a good shooting skill with an interest in making that even better. So this is reserved. Actually, Irioth has claimed this, it seems. Well, fine. Finders keepers. Oh, no, just delivering it. That's okay. I love having all of these little spots for weapons. It lets me keep myself organized so I don't have to scour through the stockpile and try to pick out what weapons we have. I just look down here and it's all set up automatically. I keep forgetting the lights. I'm so sorry. It's already 17 hours. It's been a whole day with no crops growing. Whoops. And just like that, the research and crafting room is already done, as is the new bedroom. I'm just going to unleash the floodgates and allow them to craft to their heart's desire. No, I don't. These two rooms don't look identical, do they? Something's off. I think the mine goes in the middle here. There we go. All better. Just going to let them mine whatever they feel like mining. And now, without further ado, I can queue up a simple research bench. And we have a choice between an electric tailoring bench and a regular hand-based tailoring bench. The difference is that the electric one requires three components. We just don't have that. The hand-cranked one works at 40% of the speed of the electric, so it's much slower, but it's also cheaper. And doesn't require any power either. So we're gonna go with that for right now, for lack of components. And make sure we have the power stretching all the way to the back so that our standing lamp can get juiced, as well as eventually an electric bench whenever we should choose to make one. Unfortunately, I can't queue up any of the furniture for this new bedroom because we don't have any wood, so I can't even select wood. Is there even one tree in this entire zone? There has to be at least one. There is. I found it. It's only one, but it's there. What hour is it? 0 hours. Okay, so it's still technically night. Our plants are resting. I'm going to remember to turn on the lamps today. By golly, just wait and see. And we're gonna start some research. Who's gonna be our dedicated researcher? Probably Irioth, the cannibal. This is going to become your number one goal. Even above hauling. Even above handling and training the animals. Which, by the way, I forgot to check on Blue. Let's have Blue become able to haul. Different thing. Uh-oh, muscle parasites. Eden and Ginny. Both of you. Really? Why is that? Eden, and where are both of you? Ginny's in here. Eden is nowhere to be found. Hiding in the hallway. Yeah, they're right there in front of me. How did both of you contract this? Okay. Maybe they're getting contaminated. Maybe we needed to pave the floor. That might be part of the problem. Well, what is nice and sterile? This one. It's called sterile tile. Fair enough. 3 steel and 15 silver. Keeps the room clean. Useful in hospitals to prevent infections. This is going to be kind of expensive. 15 silver apiece is not cheap, you know? It says hospitals. This is hospital. But I kind of think food would also apply to this. That takes 480 silver. We don't have that much. I'm sorry. How about a regular old, just default tile? Yeah. Just metal tile, I guess. I don't know. What's that? 5 apiece? Paved tiles, 2 apiece. Concrete is 1. We'll do paved. Not sure if this is good or bad, really. But by golly, I'm going to try it out. It'll probably take up the rest of our steel. A manhunter pack of human hunting wargs are in the area. They will roam the region. Here's the good news. That's a lot of wargs. That's not the good news, though. The good news is no one should ever go outside of our walls, and they can't go through walls. So I don't think this is going to be a problem, but we're about to find out. Here they come, barking and growling and hovering. You're not going to get us. We're safe inside of our castle keep, at least for now. It's been a fairly uneventful day in RimWorld, truth be told, of course, despite the poison that surrounds our colony, threatening to end life as we know it due to a lack of sun and easily growing crops to sustain food with winter peeking at us around the corner. If the cold doesn't kill us, starvation may. We're preparing for the worst. It may be freezing cold due to having no heaters in the colony, but we will have parkas. Will that be enough? Maybe our animals will die, our crops will die. I don't know where this is going, but stay tuned to find out more. Thank you so much for watching. My name is Etalyx. I'll see you next time.